Japanese version of Win32 API help file was my bible. You broke your computer by mistake? That's great. Why doesn't it work? Why doesn't it work? Learning to program is hard. It takes a long time. People seem to be trying hard to find a shortcut to run it as fast as possible in a smart way. That makes sense because you don't want to waste your time, but that would be a pitfall. You don't have to be so clever to master coding efficiently. Let me tell you what that means. Hi, I'm Takuya, a full stack developer from Japan. I build a whole app alone, and I write almost any language as I need. For example, I've written JavaScript, Java, Kotlin, Objective-C, Swift and C++ for building my React Native app. I've also written Python and Lua to create a video art using deep learning. There is no strict definition of full stack, but in my opinion, being a full stack developer doesn't mean you know everything. Being a full stack developer means that you can quickly adapt new technologies as much as you need, as if you know everything. Why is it possible? That's simple. Because there are no significant differences between programming languages. The paradigms of coding are basically the same, such as object-oriented programming, data structure, math threading, etc. For example, function signatures are similar regardless of languages. Say you got to find the index of the element in a certain array. In JavaScript, the signature of index of method looks something like this. The first argument is the element to locate in the array, and the second argument is the index to start the search app. You can call it like this. It returns the index if found, otherwise it returns -1. In Python, the signature looks like this, and you can call it like this. Very similar, right? In PHP, it looks like this. And if you already know index of method in JavaScript, it is not hard to understand how to call array search in PHP or list.index method in Python, right? So as you understand a particular language deeply, learning another language can be easy by reusing your knowledge and experience. This technique can be applied to frameworks as well. Once you run React, you can reuse the knowledge for running another similar framework like U or Rust. You can write a component something like this in U. As you can see, so if you are already used to writing React, you should be able to understand the U framework quickly. You will notice that there are a lot of common design and paradigms between languages like that. That's because the developer communities are influencing each other. My favorite one is that the idea of JavaScript's async await has come from C#. It's interesting, isn't it? So most ideas are a mixture of the existing ideas. So the point is that you should be deeply into a particular language and framework. In fact, how many languages and frameworks you can use doesn't matter. But how deeply you understand the language and the framework is important. Because you should have taku to solve difficult problems with them. Those experiences are the true gem that can be reused for other skills. A lot of people are obsessed to talk about the best programming language and the best library and the best framework, etc. And that doesn't make sense because they actually never exist. Instead, there are the optimal languages and library for solving your problem. So don't blindly choose what they told you. Choose technologies based on the problem you are trying to solve and stick with them. So try every technology that looks promising for you and decide which to use by yourself. So there are a lot of common principles in programming. So once you choose a dev stack, stick with it so you can cultivate your own reusable knowledge base. But how to get those knowledge efficiently? That is to make mistakes. as many as possible. I made countless mistakes while learning to code. People usually try to avoid making mistakes by reading books and articles on the internet. Of course, knowing the best practices is useful. Asking people questions is helpful. Yeah, I agree. Those are quick ways to find the answers. But there is a problem. You will never understand how they found the answers. You will never know why they do it in that way. You are just borrowing their time and effort by asking questions. On the other hand, making a mistake is the opportunity to understand them. Besides, making mistakes can be etched in your memory longer than just remembering the answers. That's something like muscle training. When I started programming at age 13, I didn't have much money to buy so many books. My home was not connected to the internet yet. So the Japanese version of Win32 API help file was my Bible. I've read it and tried Windows APIs again and again without knowing how to call them. Some APIs were not translated, so I couldn't understand the English descriptions at that time. And so I tried to specify possible parameters as many as I can come up until it works. My app and my computer crashed many, many times because I used it wrong. I was so happy when I finally got it to work. And I've learned the API signature patterns little by little. That helped me understand new APIs and also helped me design interfaces of my functions and methods. That's how I learned the basic design principles. Making a mistake is definitely not embarrassing, unlike studying at school. That's the necessary step to learn to code. I mean, you need to make a mistake. Don't be afraid. That's why I said you don't have to be clever to master coding efficiently. Cleverly avoiding mistakes is ultimately an inefficient way to learn. You broke your computer by mistake? That's great. I did it many times too. You wiped out data from the database by mistake? That's awesome. I did it many times too. So you are doing great. Keep it up. So I don't mean that you shouldn't read books or search answers on Stack Overflow. I mean that you should think with your head and use your hands. Okay? And yes, it's hard. It's even painful sometimes. And it might be not so fun when you scratch your head and mumble like, why doesn't it work? Why doesn't it work? But trust me, your effort will pay off. I was struggling to find good design patterns of object-oriented programming. My code was messed up with weird classes. But one day, I suddenly realized how to design classes well. This knowledge doesn't depend on any OOP languages, and that will make you a full-stack developer. Really. So that's how I learned to code. If you are struggling to learn programming, I hope this video is helpful. And thank you for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.